فؤادك الأيام فتى
والأصل في العادات الإباحة إلا ما ورد عن الشارع تحريمه. And the original essence of عادات is the opposite to عبادة. عادات are what? That way it's permissible. You can do anything as long as it's not an ibadah, with the condition that there is no prohibitions attached to it. The asl is that it's allowed, you can do it. Where's the evidence for that? Ayatu, Surah Al-Baqarah. The ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he says, هو الذي خلق لكم ما في الأرض جميعا. Allah created for you everything on the face of this earth. So, everything is permissible for you until it's proven to be what? So if somebody says to you, Akhi, you can't eat this animal, or Akhi, you can't wear these clothes, or you can't do wudu with this, then you say to him, where is your evidence? You're upon the asal, the istishab, which is what? The istishab, which is that i'adat is ibaha illa ma warada an al-shari'a tahrimu. That is permissible, except that which the shari'a, the legislator, prohibits. Na'am.
لأن العبادة ما أمر به الشارع أمر إيباب أو استحباب.
أمره؟
أمر به الشارع أمر به أمر إيباب أو استحباب.
إيباب أو إيجاب؟
نعم إيجاب. أمر إيجاب أو استحباب.
Why؟ لأن he's explaining it to you now. لأن العبادة because the عبادة is ما أمر به الشارع. It is that which the legislator has commanded in a what? أمر إيجاب in a forceful manner. Or أمر استحباب or in a recommended manner. So the way that the شارع will command you to come with a matter is or request from you to come with a matter is in a way where it's either forcefully or it's in a recommended manner. نعم.
فما خرج عن ذلك فليس بعبادة.
Anything that exits that point, which is what? The Shari' didn't request from you to do it in a forceful manner, nor has it requested from you to do it in a recommended manner, then this is not a ibadah. فما خرج عن ذلك أي خرج عن ماذا? What did it get out from? Meaning, أن الشارع لم يأمره أمر إيجاب ولا أمر استحباب. That the legislator didn't request from you to do this in a recommended manner, nor in a forceful manner. So, فليس بعبادة, this is not a عبادة. نعم.
ولأن الله خلق لنا جميع ما على الأرض لننتفع به بجميع أنواع الانتفاعات إلا ما حرمه الشارع علينا.
Because he says, ولأن الله, and the reason why عادات, the أصل of عادة is إباحة, is because خلق لنا, Allah created for us. جميع ما على الأرض, everything that is on the face of this earth. Why? لننتفع به, so we can benefit from it. بجميع أنواع الانتفاعات, in all of the types of benefiting. إلا except ما حرمه الشارع علينا, except that which the legislator has prohibited from us. And again, I told you, it's the ayah, هو الذي خلق لكم ما في الأرض جميعا. سورة بقرة, ayah 29. So everything we see on this earth and everything around us, Allah created for us. The shari'a comes and does what? The shari'a comes and it pinpoints things and it says, this one you can't do, this one you can't do, this one you can't do, this one you can't eat, this one you can't eat, this one you can't eat. And pay attention. What does this show us? What does this show us? That what's more, the halal or the haram? The halal is more. How do we know the halal is more? Because whatever the sharia has prohibited is within the mushaf and it's within the sunnah. And it's that countable. And the rest, because it can't count it, it said to you, if I don't mention it, it's allowed. It's too much. Na'am.
وَمِنْهَا إِذَا وُجِدَتْ أَسْبَابُ الْعِبَادَةِ وَالْحُقُوقِ ثَبَتَتْ وَوَجَدَتْ إِلَّا إِذَا قارنها الماني ما قارنها المانع.
The Sheikh said, رحمه الله, إذا وجدت أسباب العبادات, if the causes of the عبادات are present, والحقوق and the responsibilities. For example, طلوع الشمس, the sunset, the صلاة مغرب enters. Are you with me? Or عشاء enters. Are you with me? This is the sabab, the reason is present. So the sabab enters what? Ahkam al-wad'iyya. So the sabab is present. which is the timing of the salah entered, wajabat, it's obligatory on you. You see, إذا وجدت أسباب, if the reasons, the causes are present, then what? And the responsibility, ثبتت, it is present, ووجبت, and it's also obligatory on you. إلا إذا قارنها المانع, as long as there doesn't come a prevention that stops you from it. What is the prevention that may stop you from it? If a person is what? Insane. Junoon. It's an obstacle. And you're not going to do it. Or the woman is on her haidh. She's on her menstruation. But the sabab is present here, which is that the salah time has entered. But she doesn't have to do it. She doesn't have to do it. Because the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, رُفِعَ الْقَلَمُ عَنْ ثَلَاثَةِ عَنِ النَّائِمِ حَتَّى يَسْتَيْقِظَ وَعَنِ الصَّبِيحِ حَتَّى يَحْتَلِمْ وَعَنِ الْمَجْنُونَ حَتَّى يَعْقِلِ. And we're going to come to that in the other point, inshallah ta'ala. So, based on that, if the sabab is of the ibadah is found and its responsibility is present, then what do? We say that this is what? This is something that the mukallaf has to come with. The person who this is needed from has to come with it. Unless there comes an obstacle that prevents him from it. Naam.
وَمِنْهَا الْوَاجِبَاتُ تَلْزَمُ الْمُكَلَّفِينَ وَالتَّكْلِيفُ يَكُونُ بِالْبُلُوغِ وَالْعَقْلِ وَالْإِثْلَافَاتُ تَجِبُ عَلَى الْمُكَلَّفِينَ وَغَيْرِهِمْ.
The Sheikh here is saying, الْوَاجِبَاتُ, the obligatory and the mandatory is what? تَلْزَمُ الْمُكَلَّفِينَ. The obligation is upon a person who's reached takleef. And then the Sheikh is going to tell you what takleef is. What takleef, يَكُونُ بِالْبُلُوغِ وَالْعَقْلِ. It's by way of, he's reached age of puberty and he's got sanity. وَالْإِتْلَافَاتُ تَجِبُ عَلَى الْمُكَلَّفِينَ وَغَيْرِهِمْ. And now he's telling you what? That itlaf is to destroy something. A person causes a loss of something. He breaks something. Okay, he either burns a house down or everything. The Sheikh said to you, this takleef is not a condition for it. Whether he's a mukallaf or not, it doesn't matter. We'll still take it from him, even if he's a child. And he hasn't reached age of puberty. So the Sheikh is saying, the wajibat, the takleef is conditioned. Upon the mukallaf, it's obligatory. And then he told you that the takleef, يكون بالبلوغي والعقل. But then he told you, وَالْإِتْلَافَاتُ. If this person, this young child, what does he do? He's being driven by somebody. And what does he do? He pulls the handbrake, the young child. And something is caused to the car. If he's got money, it'll be taken from him. Or the child puts the handbrake down. And then the car goes into somewhere. Then I will say to you, can you get your child the money? Pay for it. The family have to pay money for it. They can't say it's a child. Lam yablugh. He didn't reach bulugh. So if he burns a house down, if he causes a family a loss of property, whether he's a mukallaf or not, even if he's insane, it's still taken from him. It's taken from him. And that you can't use the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, رُفِعَ الْقَلَمُ عَنْ ثَلَاثَةً عَنِ النَّائِمِ حَتَّى يَسْتَيْقِظْ وَعَنِ الصَّبِيحِ حَتَّى يَحْتَلِمْ وَعَنِ الْمَجْنُونِ حَتَّى يَعْقِلْ. It's not a condition here. Causes a harm, he would have to pay back. And that's what the Sheikh means. وَالْإِتْلَافَاتُ تَجِبُ عَلَى الْمُكَلَّفِينَ وَغَيْرِهِمْ أي غَيْرُ الْمُكَلَّفِينَ. نعم.
فمتى كان الإنسان بالغا عاقلا ووجبت عليه العبادة التي وجوبها عام ووجبت عليه العبادة الخاصة إذا اتصف بصفات من وجبت عليهم بأسبابها.
So the Sheikh said, فمتى whenever كان الإنسان, the person is بالغا عاقلا, he's reached age of puberty and he's got sanity. وجبت عليه, it is obligatory on him. Al-ibadatu, the ibadah is obligatory on him. Allati wujubuha amun, that which is obligation is what? It's general. Its obligation is what? It's general. Naam. Wa wajabat alayhi al-ibadatu al-khassa, and also the specific ibadat are also made obligatory on him. Idha tasafa, that is as long as he comes with what? إِذَا تَصَفَ, if he comes with the characteristics of what? بِصِفَاتِ مَنْ وَجَبَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ بأسبابها. If he comes with the characteristics of the person who this matter is made obligatory on him, if he comes with those characteristics, with its means. That's what the sheikh said. نعم.
والناس والجاهل غير مؤاخذين من جهة الإثم لا من جهة الضمان في المتلفات.
والناس, the person who's unaware, he forgot. Okay, والجاهل, and a person who's ignorant. غير, they are not مؤاخذين, both of them are not held account. من جهة الإثم, in terms of sins. Allah, in the eyes of Allah, they have no sin. So if a person who's sleeping, or a person who forgot the salah time, in the eyes of Allah, there's nothing on him, inshaAllah ta'ala, that he forgot the salah. لكن لا, but then what? He has to bring back the salah again. He has to pay it back. Okay, he can't just say, I forgot, so subhanAllah, if the time went out. No. فَلْيُصَلِّيهَا إِذَا ذَكَرَى. Also, if a person forgot a person's car somewhere, or left the keys inside the car, and they walked away and went to the shop, thinking that they had the car keys on, and the car wasn't theirs. Okay? Then, and they forgot the keys in there, we will say to you, inshallah ta'ala, in the eyes of Allah, you're not going to be a person who caused a Muslim harm. Meaning no ithm is upon you, sin. Lakin, but the sheikh said, لا من جهة الضمان في المتلفات. But not from the angle of, he has to repay back, and he has to give back the harm that he's caused. So he has to give back that car, what it's worth. So the sheikh, the la here is a negation of what? مُؤَاخَذَيْنِ. غَيْرَ مُؤَاخَذَيْنِ مِنْ جِهَةِ الْإِثْمِ. But la, it's not مِنْ جِهَةِ الضَّمَانِ فِي الْمُتْلَفَاتِ. Because he has to bring back that which he has caused a harm towards the people. نعم.
فصل قول الصحابي.
Now we're going to go into the issue pertaining to the Sahabi. What weight does it have? And the Sheikh is going to mention 4 points regarding that. نعم.
وهو من اجتمع بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مؤمنا ومات على الإيمان.
The first point is the definition of Sahabi. The Sheikh says his ta'rif here is not jami'un mani', he only mentions some of it. He said من اجتمع بالنبي, anyone who came to meet the Prophet ﷺ, came to the Prophet ﷺ. مُؤْمِنًا بِهِ, in a state of iman. وَمَاتَ عَلَى الْإِيمَانِ, and he died upon iman. You see? Now, that's a sahabi. That is a sahabi. That's the definition that the Shaykh gave. Anybody who met the Prophet. He met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he was meeting the Messenger, he has to have had iman. If he took iman after he met the Prophet, is he a sahabi? لا يسمى sahabi. He's not called a sahabi. He's only taken from him, the meeting of him and the Prophet has to be in a state of iman. Because here, مُؤْمِنًا بِهِ means حال كونه مؤمنًا. His situation has to be what? نعم. And we know the حال is قَيْدٌ لِعَامِلِهِ, that the حال, it has to be done in that situation. So he met the Prophet and he's had iman. Also, وَمَاتَ عَلَى الْإِيمَانِ, and he dies in that state of iman. He has to die upon iman. He has to die upon iman. نعم.
إذا اشتهر ولم ينكر بل أقره الصحابة عليه فهو إجماع.
If a statement he says becomes famous, and no one rejects that statement of his, rather they affirm it for him, then that statement of his is an إجماع. إذا اشتهر, if it becomes famous, his statement becomes famous amongst the other Sahabas. وَلَمْ يُنْكَرْ, and no one rejects that statement of his. بَلْ أَقَرَّهُ, rather they affirm that statement of his. فَهُوَ إِجْمَاعٌ, then this statement of the Sahabi is called a consensus. It's called a consensus. نعم.
فَإِنْ لَمْ يُعْرَفِ اشْتِهَارُهُ وَلَمْ يُخَالِفُهُ غَيْرُهُ فَهُوَ حُجَّةٌ عَلَى الصَّحِيحِ.
But فَإِنْ لَمْ يُعْرَفْ اشْتِهَارُ, we don't know whether it became famous, the statement that this Sahabi said. We don't know. وَلَمْ يُخَالِفْهُ غَيْرُ, but we also don't know anyone who opposed him. We don't know. We have no one who went against him. This is a hujjah in the strongest view. that it's a proof. How is that a proof for us? We will say first of all, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us to follow the Sahabas as a whole. And the hadith of the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لا تجتمع أمتي على الضلالة. My ummah will not unanimously agree upon misguidance. Are you with me? And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Other than the believers. Our belief in Allah is high. That if this was a wrong statement of this Sahabi, we know Allah is the one who promised that he's going to protect this religion. So he, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, who said, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَى وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We're the ones who set down the religion. And we're the ones that are going to protect this religion. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will not leave the ummah upon misguidance. Allah won't. So we say this is a hujjatun ala sahih. It's a proof. Because it won't be possible that qarnan ba'da qarnin, generation after generation, people are quoting only one sahabi or two sahabi or a handful of sahabas who said this. And there's no other opposition that we know of. Even if we don't know if it went famous. Even if we don't know, even if there was a person who disagreed with him, but we don't know it, we will say that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us to follow it. So it's an ijma'. Na'am.
فَإِنْ خَالَفَهُ غَيْرُهُ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ لَمْ يَكُنْ حُجَّةِ
If the Sahabas, they differ amongst themselves in this matter, فَإِنْ خَالَفَهُ غَيْرُهُ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ Other Sahabas differ with him in this matter. There's a khilaf amongst the Sahabas within themselves regarding this issue. Then the strongest one to the evidence is who we take it. وَرُدَّ التَّنَازُعُ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ We take it back to who of the two are closest to the evidence. And we give we stick with the one who follows the Kitab and Sunnah the closest. And you all have to remember the ayah where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala he said, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala he spoke about who? In the ayah, it's the ayah 100 in Surah At-Tawbah. Allah says, those who what? The Muhajirin and the Ansar, Allah spoke about them. And then Allah said, the one who follows them in good. So we follow the Sahabas. The ayah clearly mentions it. Also, when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say in the hadith? سَتَفْتَرِقُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى 73 فِرْقَةٍ That my ummah are going to divide into 73 sects. كُلُّهَا فِي النَّارِ All of them are in the hellfire, except one. When the Sahabas asked, Ya Rasulullah, who are the ones that are going to be saved? The Prophet said, anyone who's upon man kana ala ma ana alayhi al-yawma wa ashabi. He said, anyone who is upon that which I and my companions are upon today. And the hadith narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi and other than him. So the hadith is Hassanu li ghayri. And the riwayah that says, the narration that says, that al-jama'ah, the narration that says what? And when the Prophet ﷺ was asked, Man hiya ya Rasulullah, who is this saved sect? The Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Jama'ah. This hadith is a shahid for the part, it's a shahid. It can strengthen the narration that says, Ma ana alayhi al-yawma wa ashabi. Because who were the jama'ah that day? It was the Prophet and his companions. It was the Prophet and his companions, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, that narration shows us that if you want to be saved, follow the Sahabas. رضي الله تعالى عنهم follow them all when they unanimously agree upon a matter. If they differ amongst themselves in a matter, then العبرة the person we look up to or we take their words is أقربهم إلى النصوص الوحيين the one who is the closest to the Kitab and the Sunnah. نعم. Now we finished. The issue pertaining to the Sahabas. We finished the issue pertaining to Sahabas. We're now going to move on, inshallah ta'ala, to the chapter where the Sheikh talks about. Qawa'id that are different type. Again, he's going to take us back to Qawa'id and Dawabid Fiqhiyah, which are important that a person needs to know. Especially he's going to talk to us about the Amar and the Nahi and the Alfad al-Umum. He's going to talk to us also about what? Ijtihad and Taqlid. Okay, and this is going to be the last fasl. It's the 10th fasl, which is the last one. Naam.
Faslun qawaidu wa dawabitu fiqhiyatun mutanawwi'an.
Alhamdulillah. Yahdikum Allah wa yuslih balakum. Hey.
Faslun qawaidu qawaidu wa dawabitu wa fiqhiyatun mutanawwi'a.
The sheikh here, he's talking about qawaid, principles, and dawabit. Qa'ida is that which enters what? Different types of chapters. It enters a large number of chapters. Dawabit, on the other hand, only enters a specific chapter. Fiqhiyatun. Dawabit fiqhiyah. Mutanawwi'a, that are different. Now that heading is not very wise to give it. According to the copy that we all have, that's what it mentions. But that's not the best to give. Why? Because we just previously came from a chapter that was saying that. The previous chapter was actually what? The previous chapter was talking about the issues pertaining to usul and qawa'id that a person needs to know. Or the chapter before that, we were studying all of those things. So to bring it back again, usul and qawa'id, what would have been better is to call it al-amru wal-nahyu wa-al-fadhul umum and al-ijtihad wa-taqlid. That's all he's going to be speaking about, those three points. So only going to be talking about al-amru wal-nahyu. He's going to be talking about al-fadhul umum, words that show generalization, and ijtihad and taqlid. So I think we can go over this one quickly, inshallah ta'ala. Naam.
Al-amru bil-shay nahyun an didda, an diddihi.
When the sheikh here is saying al-amru bil-shay, a order of a matter is a prohibition of its opposite. When the sharia orders you to do something, it's always the opposite is negated from you. So if the sharia requests tells you in a forceful manner to do something, it is also forcefully prohibiting you from the opposite. And that is also a matter which is disputed. We spoke about it in more details when we were talking about it in al-waraqat. Naam.
وَالنَّهْيُ عَنِ الشَّيْءِ أَمْرُ بِضِدِّهِ وَيَقْتَضِي الْفَسَادَ إِلَّا إِذَا دَلَّ الدَّلِيلُ عَلَى الصِّحَّةِ.
Also, the second thing is وَالنَّهْيُ, the prohibition. وَالنَّهْيُ, the prohibition. عَنْ شَيْءٍ, a matter. If the sharia prohibits you from a matter, is also what? أَمْرٌ بِضِدِّهِ. The opposite is what you're being ordered to do. It's also the opposite which the sharia is doing. So here, the sheikh is teaching us here, أَمْرُ فِعْلُ الشَّيْءٍ, which is amr, and is also what? الْكَفُ عَنْ ضِدِّهِ, which is nahi. Whenever one is ordered, the opposite is also present. So when you're ordered to do a matter, which is a command, you're also prohibited from the opposite of that matter. Naam. And if you're ordered to stay away from something, then you're ordered to do it, the opposite to it. Then the sheikh said, وَيَقْتَذِي الْفَسَادَ. So the prohibition of a matter, which is an order of its opposite, it necessitates what? It means... the corruption of that matter, except if evidence shows that it's still correct. This matter is fasid. And of course, the evidence we can use for that is the hadith of مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ. Isn't that a prohibition of a matter? Isn't that also the opposite being commanded, meaning to follow the sunnah? And doesn't that also show that it's fasid, your innovation? Huh? وَيَقْتَدِي الْفَسَاد. It shows what? That this thing is null and void. You see, unless if an evidence shows what? Unless if an evidence shows that it's still correct. Now.
وَالْأَمْرُ بَعْدَ الْحَضْرِ يَرُدُّهُ إِلَى مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ.
We took this qa'ida before, which is the command of something you were prohibited for a period of time. وَالْأَمْرُ, your order to do something. بعد الحذر, after prohibition, يرده, it takes it back, that command takes it back to what? إلى ما كان, that which it was. قبل ذلك, before the prohibition, what it was. So if it was mubah, it takes it back to mubah. If it was what? And I'll give you an example of it taking it back. وإذا حللتم فاصطادوا. What was it before hunting? Mubah. Now you're being ordered to do it after prohibition. It goes back to its original form, which was what? Mubah. Mubah. نعم that's correct. أي فضل.
والأمر والأمر والنهي يقتضيان الفور.
Command an أمر and a نهي a prohibition نهي والأمر والنهي a command and a prohibition both of them you have to do straight away. If the Sharia orders you to do something, huh? Or it prohibits you from something, you have to run to do it straight away. Where's the evidence for that? Allah says, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ hasten to the good. Allah says also, the Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 48. Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hashr, ayah 7, وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنُهُ anything that the Prophet prohibits you from is what? فَانْتَهُ stay away from it. Stay away from it. The fact that the word that's used here is فَانْتَهُ stay away from it. And this shows what? It shows fawriyah. It means it shows what? يَقْتَدِ الْوُجُوبُ الْفَوْرِيَّةِ. And so you have to stay away from it straight away. نعم.
وَلَا يَقْتَدِ الْأَمْرُ أَمْرُ التِّكْرَارِ إِلَّا إِذَا عُلِّقَ عَلَى سَبَبٍ فَيَجِبُ أَنْ يُسْتَحَبَّ عِنْدَ وُجُودِ سَبَبِهِ.
وَلَا يَقْتَدِ الْأَمْرُ أي أمر doesn't entail. It doesn't entail a tikrar that it has to be done many times. If the Sharia tells you to do something, it doesn't entail that you have to do it so many times. If it tells you to do it, you just have to do it once. That's enough. Unless, illa idha ulliqa ala sababin, unless it is attached to a sabab, like time. For example, if the sun reaches this, you pray dhuhr. Whenever the dhuhr time comes, then of course you're going to have to redo that command. Because it's connected to a what? A sabab. طلوع الشمس أما the غروب الشمس, or it's connected to a sabab. So you have to always do that because it's connected to. And like, for example, Allah said, أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِدُلُوكِ الشَّمْسِ. Here, the sabab is duluk al-shams. Whenever duluk al-shams is met, the salah here has to be repeated. But if it isn't, and the shari'ah just orders you to do something, one time is enough for you. You shouldn't think of it more than once. Where's the evidence for that? The hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, rahimahullah ta'ala, in hadith Abi Hurairah, that the Prophet done a khutbah. He said, خَطَبَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The Prophet done a khutbah. And then he said, يَا أَيُّوَ النَّاسِ O people, قَدْ فَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ الْحُجَّ Allah has made Hajj obligatory on you guys. فَحُجُّوا do Hajj. فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ A man said, أَكُلَّ عَامٍ يَا رَسُولَ Every year, the Prophet went quiet. Until the man kept repeating it three times. He said it three times. Then the messenger looked at him and he said to him, لَوْ قُلْتُ If I was to say to you, نَعَمْ لَوَجَبَتْ It would have been obligatory on you. وَلَا مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ And you guys would not have been able to do it. So why did فَلَوْ كَانَ الْأَمْرُ مُكَرَّرًا If the command showed that it's repetitive, the Prophet ﷺ would not have what? He would not have scolded this Sahabi for what? The question he asked. But his question was an external question. It had nothing to do with what the Prophet said. He just asked an extra question. But if what the Prophet was saying, it was part of it, then the Prophet ﷺ would not have said to him, this statement of his. Na'am.
وَالْأَشْيَاءُ الْمُخَيَّرُ فِيهَا
And now the Sheikh is going to talk about matters which the person has a choice in. He's مُخَيَّر. He has a what? He has a choice regarding it. Na'am.
إِنْ كَانَ لِلسُّهُولَةِ عَلَى الْمُكَلَّفِ فَهُوَ تَخْيِيرُ رَغْبَةٍ وَاخْتِيَارِ
If إِنْ كَانَ لِلسُّهُولَةِ If the matter is out of way of ease on the مُكَلَّف, then this is what? فَوَ تَخْيِيرٌ It's a choice, وَرَغْبَةٍ A choice that is wanted for you. نعم, وَاخْتِيَارٌ And chosen for you. نعم.
وَإِنْ كَانَ لِمَصْلَحَةِ مَا وُلِيَ عَلَيْهِ فَهُوَ تَخْيِيرٌ يَجِبُ تَعْيِينُ مَا تَرَجَّحَتْ مَصْلَحَتُهُ
وَإِنْ كَانَ لِمَصْلَحَةِ But if it's based with a maslaha, ma wulli alayhi, which it's put with it, this takhir is what? Yajibu ta'yinu ma tarajjahat maslahatu. It becomes what? It becomes obligatory on that which the maslaha will outweigh it. It was your choice at the beginning, but now there's a maslaha stipulated to it. Huh? A maslaha is stipulated to it. Then this point right now, this takhir is obligatory on the person, on a person who can make this maslaha weigh, bring So it becomes obligatory. And for example, this would be, example would be a jihad, which is jihad al-talab. Jihad al-talab. Is jihad al-talab obligatory on every person? No, it's fardu. Jihad al-talab is fardu kifaya. If some go, not everyone has to go. Are you with me? If some people go, not everybody has to go. But the Muslim ruler, he sees that there's a person who knows how to use the bombs very well and he knows how to shoot properly and he's a good commander. This was a choice at the beginning. Huh? As long, then it becomes what on him? Because the maslaha is high when he goes, then he has to, becomes obligatory for him too.